A few weeks ago, I showed you how I built a cuboid cloud LED lamp, which created, let's just say, mixed feedback from viewers. But that is not the point right now, because the lamp is not completely finished yet. As you can see, when I flip on the lamp's power switch, it activates the lamp's GU10 LED spots, as well as the RGBW LED strips on top. The reason for that is that both components are wired up in parallel. That kind of sucks though, because you can never experience, for example, the mood lighting without having the whole room flooded with light due to the bottom LEDs. The easiest solution would be to use two switches, which each individually turn on slash off one component group. But that is not possible, because even though the ceiling offered three wires to work with, at the power switch we only got two of them. So a simple two-switch system is not possible. But since we got an RF remote for the RGBW LED strips, I will be showing you in this video how it communicates with its receiver and how we can use it to talk to a microcontroller and thus control all kinds of things, including a solid-state relay which can turn on slash off the GU10 LED spots and thus solve our initial problem. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, where you can get custom PCBs the easy and economical way. So upload your grubber files and submit your order, which includes getting a proper file review before the reproduction process. To start off, we should have a look inside the RF remote, but since I didn't want it to destroy it, I rather ordered myself another RF LED strip remote with receiver, which also do their job without a problem. So I took apart the remote in order to pull out the main PCB, which is apparently built around an RM03-CIC. Only problem was that I found absolutely no information about this IC on the internet. Thankfully though, while inspecting the three ICs of the RF receiver, I noticed this 480R IC, which according to its datasheet is an ASK-OOK RF receiver. ASK stands for amplitude shift keying and OOK for on-off keying, which are two methods used to send 1 and 0 bits through an RF signal. But right now we do not care that much about this technical principle, as well as the more or less complicated functional diagram of the IC, which in a nutshell picks up the modulated RF signal and turns it into a proper data signal that we can work with. For now, we only care about the cleaned up data signal on pin 5 of the IC, at which I immediately had a look at with my oscilloscope. As you can see by pushing a button on the RF transmitter, which I obviously had to reassemble beforehand, we get a decent looking data signal at the receiver's data output. And of course, by pushing another button, we get a slightly different data signal, which is very hard to see on the oscilloscope, but obvious, because the receiver needs a different identification signal for each button in order to know what it should do. By using the continuity function of my multimeter, I found out that this data output directly connects to a microcontroller IC, which will probably read in the data signal and then control a MOSFET, which sits right next to it, to adjust the brightness of the LEDs. And that is basically how this RF receiver works. And yes, it can also receive and demodulate the data signals from the RGBW LED strip RF remotes. But I really do not need the microcontroller and MOSFET part of the PCB. Thankfully though, since I knew that the receiver and transmitter work with a carrier frequency of 433 MHz, I simply searched for another 433 MHz receiver on eBay, and quickly found one. After receiving it, I hooked its VCC and ground pin up to 5 volts, and its data pin to the oscilloscope. And sure enough, after pushing a button on the LED remotes, I was greeted with a lovely looking data signal that we can work with. So I connected the data pin to the pin 2 of an Arduino Nano and started writing codes, so that the microcontroller uses its external interrupts to start a timer when the state of the data signal changes, while saving the on/off times of the received signal. But while trying to write this code, I realized that a way easier to use Arduino library already exists, the RC switch library. So after downloading it, opening up the receive demo advanced sketch, uploading it, opening the serial monitor, and finally pushing a button on the remote, I was greeted not only with the mandatory binary data codes, but also with the fact that the signal used the protocol 1. After doing a bit of digging in the library's wiki, I found out that the protocol is actually an encryption for the sent data, with a synchronization part, and with the bit 0 representing 1 high and 3 low times, and the bit 1 representing 3 high and 1 low time. The synchronization part was easy to spot on the oscilloscope, and after decrypting the data signal, it was exactly the same 24-bit value as the serial monitor spat out. Perfect! But of course, depending on what kind of IC your RF transmitter and receiver uses, this data encryption can be a bit different. But the datasheet should always give you more information on that. Now my secret codes for turning off slash on the GU10 LED spots will be pressing yellow and pink one after the other. So I got the decimal codes of those buttons from the serial monitor by using the simple receive demo sketch and created a simple piece of code around them which reverses the current state of the digital pin 5 of the Arduino whenever this button combination was pushed. After uploading the new codes, I hooked up an LED to pin 5 for testing and checked whether everything worked how I wanted it to, which it did. But of course, in order to control mains voltage, we would need something like a relay, about which you can learn the basics in one of my previous videos. Anyway, after building up a small demonstration circuit with this generic relay board, it worked just like I thought it would. But honestly speaking, I do not put a lot of trust in those relays, because I often experienced that after a few weeks of usage, their changeover contacts got locked in one position due to sparking. So a relay could easily fail, which is why I tore down my demonstration circuit and instead got myself a solid-state relay board. This G3MB-202P SSR probably consists of a triac with a sprinkle of complementary components for safety reasons, which means it does not use mechanical components for switching, but instead does it electrically. But of course, if you want more information about solid-state relays, then I would once again recommend checking out one of my previous videos. Anyway, after hooking up the Arduino as well as the GU10 LED spot replacement to the SSR, it was time for testing, which as you can see turned out successful. At this point I expected to build a small additional circuit for the solid state relay, since I wanted to turn on when the Arduino outputs a low voltage signal. But apparently, the board the relay came with already featured such a circuit, and thus when the Arduino fails, the lights will still be turned on. So next I soldered all of the required components onto an additional piece of perf board, and to one another with solder bridges and bridge wire according to my small finalized schematic. As soon as the circuit was complete, I grabbed myself a 5V power supply with more than enough output current capabilities and wired it up to power the circuit. After then turning on the power, it seems like everything worked, and I can turn off slash on the lights with the RF remote. But later I realized that the receive range of the circuit was quite horrible, So, as an afterthought, I was pretty much forced to remove its data signal to the Arduino and replace it with the data outputs of the previous receiver circuits, which I had to hook up to 5V power as well. This way, the range of the transmitter and receiver system was drastically improved. So it was finally time to unscrew and lift up the lamp's top MDF piece, hook up the circuit's power supply to mains voltage along with the LED power supply, and add the solid-state relay in series to the GU10 LED spots. After closing everything up, we cut a rectangle hole into the MDF boards for easier possible troubleshooting later on, and got the lamp back in position. And as you can see, it still works perfectly fine, but now I can turn off the GU10 LED spots whenever I want. I hope you enjoyed this small project and maybe got inspired by it to control something on your own with an existing RF remote. As always, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!